You ready for that blast core?
Better not wake up in a militia cage.
Come on, man, I got your back.
Oh, man.
Ooh. Glad you're awake. There's some idiots down there shooting up anything that moves.
Yeah, I'll take care of them. Give me a chance to see if I got anything new.
Sort of glow on that guy. You do that?
No, but I feel it. It's Rayfield energy.
That guy must have been around when they were testing the sphere or something.
Screw y'all. Screw AA.
You gotta get more of whatever that guy had on him.
Hell yes.
What? I mean...
You might want to come on back. I just got some good news. That and I just met your pal from the swamp. But then she disappeared. Now she's here again. It's confusing.
You inspired me.
Here.
Bunch of Bertrand's bullies got drunk and took a joyride in our ambulance. Our med supplies are scattered everywhere. Bring them back, and we'll promise to treat your injuries whenever you need it.
Lots of process.
That makes no sense.
Someone thinks they're invincible.
Thank you. Now we can open up a clinic around here. Come by anytime.
Astounding!
The exact nature of the Empire threat remains unknown at this time. But that hasn't stopped many from voicing their own theories on what is behind this wave of destruction. Is it a storm?
Oh,
a terrorist cell? An act of God? Our own meteorologist, Dwayne Culper, says the southerly route of the phenomenon goes directly against the movement of the Gulf Stream, which causes weather patterns like storms and hurricanes to move from south to north along the East Coast. He says this behavior doesn't match any known weather-based activity. I just received word we've lost contact with Tad Mitchell, our correspondent at Camp Lejeune, as the Empire threat passes through North Carolina. Our prayers go out to Tad and to all the Marines stationed out there. God bless you all.
Let's hear science explain that one.
My friends, let us pause a moment. Remember the dark time. Remember how the monsters swarmed out of the swamp. They came and they slaughtered us by the hundreds. Whole families dragged from their homes, torn apart in front of their neighbors. The police were useless, ill-prepared. The monsters cut them all down like a thresher through wheat. We were left defenseless. When I saw our town's great need, I knew what must be done. I organized the militia. Look where we are today. Order is restored. You can walk down your street without fear. Still, our work is far from over. We still have monsters out there attacking our barricades, trying to get in. And we have new threats. Freaks walking among us like men, with unholy powers God never intended. The need for the militia is greater than ever. I never asked for anything in return, but if you're grateful for all we've done, here's your chance. The militia's recruiting good young fighting stock to bolster our ranks. This is the best time to act. Generous sign-in and referral bonuses are available. But be warned, if we fail to meet our quota by the end of the month, we'll be forced to press eligible men into service.
I tell you guys, spying on this militia, and it's taken years off my life. But boy, is it worth it.
You found out where they're keeping quo.
Bertrand's got all his veterans protecting an old cane plantation. Word is, they got all the serious, deviants caged up in there.
That's that place with the streetcar out front, yeah?
That's one.
Got an idea. We fill the streetcar up with explosives, we get it going real, real fast, we ram it through the front door, and boom!
Fire will make a great diversion.
But, folks left caged up there will be burned alive.
Oh, come on, Zeke. I mean, if we do this thing with any sort of precision, we're gonna need a much bigger team.
Militia's been parading around cages full of cops. These guys used to fight against them.
You think we break them out? Give them guns?
Wait. Free cops? No. If we do that, I'm out.
Now think about it, Cole. Putting some ex-cops back on the street? Hell, that could pay off in the long run.
Screw that, man. Don't you want to see that place burn, baby? I know you do.
Whatever. It's your call, Chief.
Don't get soft on me, Cole. Those cops will turn on you first chance they get. Let's burn that place down.
Sure packing a lot of heat just to humiliate some police.
It'll be worth it. The cops in those cages are just a fraction of who they got back at the plantation. Bust those boys out, you're gonna have a hard time holding them back.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah. survive anything that I've given you. You keep vow for love and power. Safely.
Bring your friends. Grab a rifle off one of those militia. Let's go!
Make some pain! Militia assholes!
Head to that carriage house out back. I think that's where they got her.
Thank you. border? Can't get her out with guns like that around.
Guns around the back.